This is summer 2020, paper 1-2, question 7. When aqueous bromine is shaken with cyclohexane and allowed to stand, two layers form. The top cyclohexane layer is colored and the bottom aqueous layer is almost colorless. Now, what is the most likely explanation for this observation? A, bromine is reduced to bromide ions in the bottom layer. B, bromine molecules are nonpolar. C, bromine reacts with water but cannot react with cyclohexane. D, the product of the reaction between bromine and cyclohexane is colored. Now, let me show you a slide on this. Okay. Now, this is what happens when we have aqueous halogen solution, chlorine, bromine, or iodine. Then we shake, we add a small amount of cyclohexane into the aqueous solution and then we shake. And we let it stand for a while to allow it to settle to layers. Why do we see two layers? Because cyclohexane is an organic compound. Okay, it's an organic solvent. Aqueous means the molecules are dissolved in water. So cyclohexane as an organic compound, and it is an alkane, it is a nonpolar compound, it will not dissolve in water. These two layers are not miscible. That's why you see as two, just like oil layer always float on water. So cyclohexane is just like the oil layer that's floating on water. So you see two layers. Now all the halogen molecules, they are nonpolar. Cl2, Br2, I2. Okay, all these molecules, all these halogen molecules, they are nonpolar. So they actually dissolve better in cyclohexane compared to water. So when you shake cyclohexane together with water, what will happen is the molecules, the Cl2, Br2, and I2 molecules, okay, from the water, from the aqueous solution, is extracted into the cyclohexane. And they appear as this colorful solution when they dissolve in cyclohexane. Okay, that is why for this question, let's go back to the question. Okay, why do you observe the two layers, and then why do you see the colored solution, okay, in the cyclohexane? It's simply because bromine molecules are nonpolar, so they dissolve better in cyclohexane. They are being extracted to cyclohexane when the aqueous bromine is shaken with cyclohexane. Okay, not because it is reduced to bromide ion in the bottom layer, right? It is not because bromine reacts with water but cannot react with cyclohexane. Actually, bromine does not react with both water and cyclohexane. It stays as a molecule in cyclohexane. Okay, it dissociates a little bit in water, but it's not a reaction. And then the product of the reaction between bromine and cyclohexane is colored. No, actually, bromine is still a molecule in cyclohexane. So the answer is B.